back in the 1950s, when an organization had been launched in New York called SOS Children's Villages by Maurice Strong, there was allegedly a revolutionary movement in Kenya, in Africa, named the Mau Mau. And in 1954, Maurice Strong, who's now hiding out in China, went to Kenya representing Caltex in opening up a chain of gas stations in the interior of Kenya. Interesting job, because that was during the high period of the alleged Mau Mau uprising. The British arrested a man who spoke perfect English, whose name was Obama. Every indication this was Obama's grandfather. If you dig into the archives at Harvard University, there's a set of papers donated by Maurice Strong, which makes twice a reference to Mau Mau oath ceremonies. So here's what comes down, at least for my simple mind. Obama's grandfather and Maurice Strong developed a cannibal oath ceremony to entrap the new leaders of the Kenyan government in the mid-1950s. So post-independence, Kenya as a sovereign state would not be controlled by freely elected people drawn from the public wheel, if that's the right word, but they would be controlled by this apparatchiks of oath takers. And my sense, my understanding of the Mau Mau oath is it applies unto the third or fourth generation. So Obama's grandfather would have committed his son and his grandson to abide by the oath allegedly attributed to the Mau Mau. So when Barack Hussein Obama went to Kenya in 2007, my sense is he was bound to the settlement movement, which is international, through some disgusting oath that relates to cannibalism. And he worked with his cousin Odinga on setting up a fraud in the election by contacting his friends and colleagues in SOS Children's Villages, who had taken these kind of oaths involving some kind of perverse behavior with children. So that at the end of 2007, when Kenya had held its national elections, Obama's cousin Odinga was able to accuse the Kenyans of vote rigging for the then incumbent prime minister's re-election. So in January, Obama with his BlackBerry, provided by Canada, allegedly with the clipper chip in the back, triggered a Kenya genocide, where hundreds of locals were killed, including a particular incident at a place called, I think it's a Bocha, where women and children were inside a church, and when they tried to escape, they were shot with bows and arrows and pushed back into the church, which was set fire. So around 30 or 40 people, including babies, were burnt to death. This was fresh after a trip by your president. He aided and abetted a genocide. And he won't defend himself. He will not crawl out of the woodwork. Because if he does crawl out of the woodwork, the whole rotten, stinking edifice based in Chicago is going to come apart. So we've really got a situation where the enemy is deeply embedded, well camouflaged. It's using advanced military-grade encryption system. And it's able to take a legitimate process, let's say a war game exercise, and mount what they call a man-in-the-middle attack, and then attribute it to any party or faction which is intimidated by these oath-taking ceremonies, and the entire country goes off at a tangent.